You have to unmute. Looks good.
There we go.
Hi, there you are.
Hi.
I can hear you.
Cool.
Guys look great.
I thought it was kind of funny. We're getting kind of dressed up to do a gig in our own living room.
That is kind of funny, isn't it?
Well, we sort of dress up for our live shows.
All right, digging the hat. That's cool.
Thank you. Well, yeah, I haven't had a hair appointment in a long time. So, how does it sound?
Sounds good. Sing a little.
What?
That's two.
Yeah, sing a little. Sounds really good.
Okay.
Sounds good, guys. Thanks so much.
The guitar's in balance because it sounds loud to me.
No, it actually is a little bit heavy on the against the voices. I'm not sure if the answer is taking the voices up a little or taking the guitar down. I don't know.
Bring the guitar down just a fraction, and then keep in mind the picking song will bring it up a fraction.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah?
Yep.
That okay, made, and that then made we'll good boost it a little bit for the picking song.
Okay.
And then, do you have a way of telling me if we're, like, doing something really bad?
Can you see chat from where you are?
Let me see if I can turn it on. Okay. Yeah, I can read that.
Yeah, that's how I would talk to you guys directly, yeah.
So let me actually expand this. Okay, so when we're performing, you'll just have us up there, right?
Yeah, it'll be like this. It'll be like spotlight.
Ah, okay.
There's Marilyn. She's watching now, too.
Hi, Lee.
Hello.
Hi, Michael. Marilyn Cooney here. Shoot.
Oh, my computer's trying to update.
Oh, timing is everything.
Yeah. Oh, where'd you go?
I can still hear you and see you, so.
Okay, well, I lost you.
You gotta do more testing, or are we done?
Yeah, I have everything that I need, guys. Okay. Hey, Marilyn, you want to, hang on a second, let me take the spotlight off. Okay, here we go. Give me just a moment.
Yep.
There you go. Oops, you're blurry.
You can fix that.
Okay. There you are. Excellent. You got Waikiki. I love it. That's great.
Yeah.
It looks fabulous. Okay, give us a little. Give us a little bit.
the sky, green hills down to the bay. Swimming with the turtles, dolphins leaping in the air. Hack priming up the crater, trade winds blowing through my hair.
Sounds good. Looks good. Sounds good.
Is that all right?
Yeah. That's all, right. That's all I need. Is there anything that you need from me?
No, I think that's it. I'm excited. Right.
Yeah, me too. Yay. Okay, you can turn off. You can just come back in 30 minutes, or you can just turn off your vid, whatever you want to do. All right. Stephanie.
What's up, Tim Heitman?
What's happening? Hey there.
Oh, you hear me. I'm so glad.
I can
glad.
Hear you. Spotlight.
Can you see me, darling?
Yes.
Wonderful.
I can see two different views of you now. This is great. Three views.
Brooks is like.
Yeah, he's having fun. That's a beautiful yep. thing.
Let me just give you the end of a song so I can see if my belt is going to be okay.
Okay.
Let me smoke for 3 weeks in unventilated spaces. I'll take Samoa for my next vacation flight, 'cause that's where smoking is a civil right. Give me that nicotine scene. Yeah.
Kaboom. Yeah. Did I sense a little bit of reverb happening there?
Yes.
Excellent.
Brooks goes.
Sounded good. Looks good. Yeah, that's solid. That's everything I need. You good to go?
Thank you.
Okay. We'll see you in a few minutes.
Should we mute ourselves, or
yes.
will you handle that?
Well, I'll be muting everybody at the beginning, but the mute you have your own mute. You have your own mute control.
We need to unmute ourselves and
yeah.
mute ourselves again, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I will do the mute at the top of the show of everybody, but then you need to handle everything else after that.
Okay.
Ready?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. We'll see you.
Okay. So we can hang out here and turn the camera off and sound off, you know, or we can go back in 20 minutes. It's totally up to you, Brooks. Whatever you want to do.
Ah, very nice. Dave, you're a godsend. Thank you so much for this. Do you want to do a little sound check?
Do you have any artists left to go? Artists first.
Got them all. They all
wow.
started early, actually. So
impressive.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let me jiggle a thing here. Okay, that's good, that's good. Add Jackie DeMuro to the cast. That's interesting. Nope, we want this to play. Okay, ready for me?
I'm ready.
Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use, yes?
You can take both you and the music down about good 25%, I think. Okay. So I can do that myself too on my own computer, just to see how that, because that was, I'm only 66%, so.
Yeah, I'll sing that loud.
That's just me, but I'll, change the zoomy thing here.
Yeah.
Okay, take two. Actually, I spent some time trying out the sharing computer sound again, and it reminded me that when you do that, it doesn't always sync the audio and the microphone.
I didn't realize that. That's not so good.
I've heard other people report that, and I think I detected it, so it was a little weird. So back to the Bluetooth speaker sitting next to my laptop.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, take two. Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me, let's fly away.
Okay, I think we overcorrected the music just a little bit. We can come up just a little tad.
Okay, take three. Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Like that?
Very nice.
I keep going till I hit the bridge. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come on, fly with me, let's float off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide, starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. You may hear angels cheer, 'cause we're together. That's most of the song. That was all good?
That was all very good.
Cool.
So you
hit on a good track. That one is just once through in a tag.
Nice. Okay, good.
Which seemed appropriate.
Great. Do you have any other questions about the lineup or what you're doing? Or
Nope. I think we're good. I got it all written down. I may look a little glassy-eyed, but I'll get it right.
Like I said, I really appreciate this. And so does Scott. Yay.
Yeah, I hope Scott gets back together quickly.
Yeah, me too.
But I guess it sounded like it's this is not the first time. So
It isn't. It happens on occasion. So just know how to deal with it is all. Okay, so you can either hang out or you can turn off and come back at 7:25, whatever works for you.
I'm just going to let this sit here, actually.
All right, very good.
Not going to mess with success.
Good.
Remember to put my hat on before.
Yes.
Game time.
Hey, look at that. There you are. Oh, that's brilliant. I love it. That is so Sinatra.
I had a bow tie failure, but I've got the hat anyway.
Okay. I'm gonna mute you. There we go.
turn my video on now.
Kathy, your video is on.
Yes.
Your sound is on.
Yes, I was helping my mom get set up too. So mom, you just have to unmute and turn on your video. Yep. And turn on your video, the one right next to it.
Oh, all right, thank you.
Yep, I'm gonna hang up the phone because we can see you.
Hello. Okay. Hello, Richard. It's labeled Richard on your video.
Okay. Are we supposed to be on these, our picture's supposed to be there?
Yeah, it can be. Yeah, we can say hello. It's a chat until they start, so.
Oh, I see. Okay, I didn't
It looks like I see it, Marilyn, but I see that she's here. I don't actually hear her yet. Maybe she's doing her la-la-las to warm up her voice.
Okay. All right, am I okay where I am?
Yep, you can hang, Mom, you can put the phone down. I hung up there. You're hearing me through the phone. Sorry, I should have told you. It's late there, I know. It's really
right here, you know, in New York. But okay. So we're gonna have our pictures up there during the show.
We can turn them off during the show, I'd imagine. It's up to you.
Certainly can, if you want.
Yeah.
I don't even know how to do that.
You just the video where you remember at the bottom left it says stop video. You can mute too. I'll probably mute once they start singing, but you can.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Alrighty.
Yeah.
Okay.
So what table have we been assigned to? Is it a prime table?
It's hard to do that in the virtual world, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah.
I wondered about that too. I wanted a good seat.
Yeah. I'm just glad we were able to find a way to do this sort of thing.
No, it is fun that you're.
The nice thing about it is we can actually do it from all over the world, actually. Not just all over the country, but I'm having a cabaret tonight with one person from Southern California, one person from Northern California, and someone else from Oregon. I mean, come on. How wonderful is that?
And nobody has to travel or stay in a hotel or...
Yeah.
We ran a small festival, and it was really... We had people from all over the world, and it was just really fun. Couldn't do that normally. They wouldn't show up for... They wouldn't fly for 24 hours to be here for an hour.
I'm looking forward to the possibility, once we actually all can start meeting again, is incorporating this sort of thing into what we do already.
Yes.
You know, being able to actually have videos in the theater so that folks that are in New York or elsewhere can participate.
I love that.
That's a great idea. It's something that we all thought about but never really jumped into before. But now we've all gotten kind of used to this.
Everyone can Zoom now.
Yeah, we're all into it now. I think it'd probably be a whole lot easier to try and make it happen. So,
yeah.
I'm looking forward to that.
That would be great.
Is Uncle John singing tonight too, or just Aunt Marilyn?
Just Aunt Marilyn.
I see John is here too.
He's doing I guess it's five songs, but they're all together. So I don't know what she's singing.
No, I don't either. I'd be surprised.
I don't see it.
It'd be a surprise.
But, you know, she's worked hard to get where she is, and she does well.
I remember going to one of her lessons when I was visiting her in San Francisco. It was really fun. Yeah, she might be listening. We should probably say nice things about her.
Well,
Good idea. Yep, she's probably listening. She might even be recording this.
That's true. She might. Blackmail.
Yes, she is. Yes, she is.
Yes, she is. That's brilliant.
Hi.
I love you. The beach is beautiful.
Oh, more about that later.
Yeah.
Hi, Lori.
I'm Marilyn. I didn't expect to be chatting like this. It's interesting.
Yeah. You met Tim, who's in charge of all this wonderful
society.
He's done so much for us for live music. Oh, and there's Nancy.
Hi.
Hi.
Nancy is my friend from New York from hundreds of years ago. I know
hundreds
of
years?
That old.
Wow, that's good. You guys look real good for that. That's great.
That's us.
Did I meet Nancy? I think I met Nancy at Grandma's house one time. Did she come visit?
Yes, that could very well be.
Yep. I remembered her boots. You're the same person. They were very impressive. But I remembered
my niece Kathy.
Boots that I thought were very pretty.
Hey.
That's my niece Kathy, Lori's daughter.
Right.
Yeah.
Hi, Nancy.
Hi, how are you?
I'm great. Everybody's great. We've got to all be great, right?
Right.
Right. Right. Positive. Yeah. Yeah. Good to see you. It's been years.
Yeah.
Many, many years. But it's nice that you're still in touch. That's great.
Yeah. Wouldn't miss it.
Where are you living?
We're in Rockville Center.
Oh, you are, right on Long Island.
Yeah.
I do too. It was so beautiful up there.
Yeah, I really miss it, but no going back.
No going back. Right?
But it's snowing. It's going to snow tonight, another 6 inches.
Yeah. Oh, you've got 6 inches. You've got a lot of snow hitting Long Island. You know, we used to beg for a snow day in my way back, and it was a rare thing. And now I watch the weather and you guys get plastered.
Right. Yep. Oh, look at that.
They even have snow days now that we have Zoom and everybody's doing distance learning.
My grandchildren had a snow day on Tuesday. They had no school, no Zoom, no anything.
I know one governor said that he was going to still have snow days because it wasn't fair for kids to, they're missing out on anything. The joy of snow days.
Well, one group of kids goes to real school on Tuesday and Thursday, and they lived up near Tug Hill. So they closed the school, I guess, maybe, so those real people weren't going to have a treacherous ride to school. I don't know. My grandchildren go on Wednesdays and Fridays, so to real school.
It's real school.
Real school.
Wow. It's crazy. It's crazy. It really is. Mm-hmm. Well, this is interesting. I didn't anticipate this.
That's my sister, Laurie Saunders. She lives in the boonies of upstate New York.
Boonies, Boonville.
Yeah.
Okay.
Tim, will you mute us all when the singing starts?
So I will indeed mute everybody. I will do that, yes. But in the meantime, feel free to talk amongst yourselves.
Yeah, no, I just wanted to check. Mm-hmm. I try to be tech support sometimes.
I appreciate that.
I have the joy of trying to be an assistant tutor to a six-year-old here in San Diego, and it is crazy trying to do on Zoom.
Yeah. Oh, they have so little attention span. Like, I can't imagine trying to keep them. Can't chase them down or anything.
We try to read a book, and if she'll start to read something, she'll hold it up to point to a word, and the book's over there. And
can't see it.
These are different times. They sure are. Yeah. I have three of them here at once working on their Chromebooks on 2 days a week. Mm-hmm. So I know all about it. It's amazing. Good thing you're there for your granddaughter.
Yeah. And someone typed in the chat, homeschooling is difficult for the best of us, certainly. Yeah. I work from home, and a bunch of my coworkers, you hear them, we're on these really important meetings, and they're trying to bounce a baby while they're on the Zoom. And it makes me really glad that I don't do that.
You don't have to put me on, that's okay.
So where is this being Zoomed from?
Depends on your perspective. I'm in San Diego.
Well, that's what I wondered, where you were.
But the performers, one of them is in Southern California. One of them is in, where Maryland's from. And one of them's from Oregon. So they're coming from all across the West Coast here.
Well, I applaud you for doing this. It's great.
Thank you. Absolutely. This has been a lot of fun. It's been a great learning experience. We're still learning. We're having a great time doing. We have an open mic night once a month. We just had one last night, and we were just kind of discussing it. Maybe we ought to all someday, when all this is over, take our open mic night. We call it Curtain Call. Take Curtain Call to New York and do it somewhere there in one of those cabaret spaces and out and about near Times Square or something. You know, go see some shows, have some people over, and have some dinners out there. It'd be a lot of fun. That'd be a good trip.
Yeah, that would be a lot of fun. New York.
I'm ready.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Did you debut in New York City, Aunt Marilyn? Wouldn't you?
That would be fun, wouldn't it?
Yeah. It's fun to do that, and it's really fun to do that with a group of people that you know and appreciate, and you know.
And that they appreciate you too.
Yeah, absolutely. Take a couple of tours.
Tim and Paula, his wife, and Scott and Chris, their partners, had a wonderful club in the Hotel Rex in San Francisco for years with a beautiful showroom that we all were privileged to perform in. I was a casualty of corporate greed, I believe. We still have that, and was changed into meeting rooms by the hotel. But they carry on in various other locations, so we're very grateful for that.
And now our location is in the ether.
Yes.
For the time being, yeah. Until we all can get some vaccinations.
Yes.
Looking forward to that.
Yes.
Well, you're a glow man on the totem pole.
I am so far.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then, of course, it isn't just getting the vaccinations, but then having had them for a while and having had it all tested, because it's going to be interesting to see how this rolls out. Who will be the first kind of entertainment to gather together? I mean, sports has been sort of being able to do it because they can be in clumps across those stadiums and whatnot. Once you have to go inside of a building, then how do you do it? And who's going to want to do it? That's why I'm thinking it'll be really nice to be able to bring this hybrid in, and I can have a cabaret space and have some people who are uncomfortable coming to a space like that, sitting down and watching the show, and everybody else can watch it on video. If I have the video equipment there, we can actually do the Zoom part of it as well. So have a little hybrid, is what I'm thinking.
I think that's a great idea.
Mm-hmm. That way I can include people. And then, of course, we also have the added advantage of being able to include people from all over the world, you know, people in New York or whatnot. One of our singers at one of our open mic nights was from Florida. He used to be one of our regulars in San Francisco, but then he moved out of town, moved to Florida, and then said, well, I'm going to go ahead and still try one of these. And he sang from Florida. Of course, it was kind of late there, you know, because we started ours at about 7:15, and so that's what, 10 o'clock, 10, 15, something like that? So that can be an issue.
That was different, yeah. We had a sunny day here. There's probably a foot of snow on the ground. It just kind of keeps coming, but it was very crisp.
But it was in the 60s.
Yeah, we hit 45.
Oh dear! It doesn't make me miss upstate New York at all.
Well, you must come back and visit anyway. It's been a long time.
It has been. It has been. It'll probably be warm when I come up, though. Not winter.
Okay, I'll hold you to it.
Oh, I see some more good friends of mine just came in. Suzanne Turek is down there in the bottom right-hand corner, my good buddy here in California. Joanna Gray is here, good singer. And the Zamoras are here.
She's got a different view.
Well, we're getting close to the 10:30 mark, aren't we?
Getting close.
I love that picture of you, Marilyn.
Yeah, I like that picture of you and John.
Daddy Look who's Campbell. Here, Mr. Cooney himself.
Yeah, that's good.
Can you send that to me? I like that.
Yes. John, you can unmute yourself and talk if you want.
I'm checking to make sure I have a neutral background here.
Everybody has become a television producer all of a sudden.
Yeah, exactly.
Who knew? How's your TV show coming? There you go.
Well, you hear lots of stories about people that didn't check their background and were sorry later.
Well, I didn't check mine.
I think you're okay. But they've had like stories. You hear people like their partner didn't know they were on Zoom, and they wandered in their underwear.
Oops.
Yeah, I've seen things like that myself. When I'm on the other program there with Marilyn.
Oh yeah.
People don't realize that their background is on. People walking through and all.
Yes.
Marilyn has become an expert with the virtual background.
Yeah, she is really good at that.
Yeah.
I don't know how that's done, but it's neat. It really is. You can go anywhere in the world or anywhere in the country and have that background. It's super.
I'm glad to help you, Mom, if you want.
You can do that?
Yeah.
Well, I'm still working on other technology, as you know. It has to be very simple or I'm not ready.
Just let me know if you want help.
Suzanne and John, are you there? Guess not.
Or maybe they haven't unmuted yet.
Hi. Yes, I'm here.
Hi there.
Hi.
Is it Zani?
Oh, yeah.
Zani, is that how you say your name?
Zan.
Zan. Hi, Zan.
Zan. Hi.
Oh, you don't know who you're talking to. Marilyn. Marilyn here.
Hi, Marilyn.
Hi.
I saw you last night.
Yes, at the open mic.
Mm-hmm. That was wonderful. That was very wonderful.
It's a great thing that Tim creates, yes.
A lot of great tunes last night. A lot of great song selections. That was really tough. It was very fun.
Deborah Magnani's here.
Hi.
Hey, Deborah. Another great singer that I work with at McCathy Holly Group. Hey, girl.
Hey. Break a leg. Oh, you're in blue Hawaii. Woo.
Yes, indeed. Carol Luckenbach has come, and June is here.
Eileen and Dave.
Okay, folks, I'm going to go ahead and mute everybody and we're going to get started, okay?
Got 23 people.
That's good. Now, we have to get rid of them.
Hello, everyone, and welcome on board Society Airlines. I'm Dave Schweisguth. Scott Lacey was to have been your pilot, but he isn't feeling well today. He'll be back soon, but just for tonight, Tim asked me to take over the controls. There are reasons not to travel these days, but fly with Society and you can leave your worries behind. Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come on, fly with me, we'll float off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide, starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. You may hear angels cheer, 'cause we're together. Weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. Just say those words and we'll beat the birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's perfect for a flying honeymoon, they say. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Come fly with us, let's fly away. We have three fabulous tour guides tonight who will take you along on their travels in song. First, I would like to introduce Marilyn Cooney. She is a singer, a songwriter, and a pianist who performs originals and standards in San Francisco venues such as Villa d'Este, The Purple Onion, Martuni's, Society Cabaret, and various Bay Area retirement communities. Her CD of 16 original songs made its debut at a sold-out show in New York City, and tonight she'll take us on a musical journey through her own compositions. A warm welcome, please, for the wonderful Marilyn Cooney.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you so much, Tim and Dave and Society Cabaret, for all you do for live music. What would we do without you? Well, my dear husband and I aren't very interested in fancy cars or big houses or jewelry or clothing. We like to, if we have a little extra money, we like to have an adventure instead. So, and it always seems to happen that every time we have an adventure, I write a song about it. So I'm going to be sharing some of those with you tonight. The first place we're going, as you can see, is beautiful Hawaii. Here's how it happened. Our dear son was stationed in Honolulu in the Coast Guard. Poor thing, huh? So we thought, we can't just let him suffer there in silence, even though he was there with the beautiful woman who was to become his wife. So we packed our bags and we went down there. And during that time, I wrote this song, which is also about how grateful I am for my husband. Strolling down the beach with you down Hawaii way. Rainbow in the sky, green hills down to the bay. Swimming with the turtles, dolphins leaping in the air. Climbing up the crater, trade winds blowing through my hair. You've given me the life I dreamed would come true. Carefree, precious moments with you I recall. Long after we left this port of call, this port of call. In pretty island shops, we idled the hours away. Surfers ride the waves, aloha, the locals say. Sunset so pretty, music in the old hotel. People in the park, we both come to love so well. You've given me the life I dreamed would come true. Carefree, precious moments with you I'll recall. Long after we've left this port of call, this port of call. Dinner at the luau, to and fro the dancers sway. Hanging out with friends, oh how we all would love to stay. You've given me the life I dreamed would come true. Carefree, precious moments with you. My love, oh carefree, precious moments with you. Carefree, precious moments with you. Can you all hear me? Okay. Well, the next song is because I was born and raised in New York. As you can see in the snowy background. But I don't regret that in 1973, I put everything in my car and headed west. I can still remember my mother standing in the doorway, waving bravely goodbye as I took off in my car. I was very privileged to be able to return to my home many times over the years. Here's my tribute to my two homes. New York gave me winter, red and gold and fall. Spring and summer melted me, gladly I recall. Staten Island ferry, fancy evening gowns, bright Long Island beaches, late nights on the town. Childhood years and early love, New York saw me through. Greenwich Village, Broadway shows, strolling the avenue. Places make us, places break us. Streets remember our names. Houses haunt us, people we knew stand still in the doorway frames. California freedom, Golden Gate in sun, fall and winter welcoming, road trip highway one. Calistoga vineyards, cable cars and shores, supper clubs and music, houses, open doors. Working years and love anew in California thrived. Through twilight years and twists of fate, we all learn to survive. Places make us, places break us. Streets remember our names. Houses haunt us, people we knew stand still in the doorway frames. Places make us, places break us. Streets remember our names. Houses haunt us, people we knew stand still in the doorway frames. Thank you. Of course, this is what was waiting for me, beautiful California Coast Highway. And who else was waiting for me was himself, Mr. Cooney. And here's a little tip, my lady friends. It's a cautionary tale. On his 60th birthday, I made the mistake of asking Mr. Cooney how he wanted to celebrate, and I thought he was going to say, well, let's go down to that local Italian restaurant. But no, he had bigger ideas. So this song records that magical birthday trip to Paris. I remember the day we walked the length of the Champs-Élysées. High atop the arch, tired and parched, we could see miles away. Do you remember when we followed the banks of the River Seine? Bookstalls with their wares, artists without cares, life was simpler then. Paris, oh, the magic of Paris. Everyone writes about Paris. So I'm adding one more song. City of light, I've been gone much too long. City of love, it is here I belong. Wearing fancy French berets, we heard music in a Montmartre cabaret. Then down the steps we flew to catch the last train we knew to our cozy hideaway.
biked in Bois de Boulogne, oh, the sights on the train down to Loudon. At Notre Dame we said a prayer, in a club we danced with flair, Americans alone. Paris, oh, the magic of Paris, everyone writes about Paris, so I'm adding one more song. City of light, I've been gone much too long. City of love, it is here I belong. Romantic rendezvous. Your birthday at the Bethlehem Fontainebleau. To me, the Louvre was fun. You preferred Verdun, and Mona Lisa asked for you. We biked in Bois de Boulogne. Oh, the sights on the train down to Loudon. At Notre Dame, we said a prayer. In a club, we danced with flair. Americans alone. Everyone writes about Paris, so I'm adding one more song. City of light, I've been gone much too long. City of love, it is here I belong. City of light, it is here I belong. Thank you. Well, our next journey, we found ourselves in a tour bus in a very long line, trying to go from Chile to Argentina across these beautiful Andes Mountains. Well, after a while, our bus driver took all our passports and took a bottle of wine, got out of the bus and went to the border, came back 5 minutes later without the bottle of wine, with all our stamped passports, and immediately pulled out of the line, and we were into Argentina in no time. Business as usual, we were told. During that tour, we learned about the original peoples, the Mapuches, who lived in the mountains. We learned about the foreign nations who invaded. And we learned about all the natural disasters. And what struck me as I wrote a song that night in the hotel was that these mountains stood tall and proud through it all. Across the Andes, the ancient Andes, through the clouds their peaks do proudly show. Across the ancient Andes, following the trails of long ago. Argentina to the east, Chile to the west, Guadalajara's Bariloche, here we stop to rest. Centuries of journeys put each traveler to the test. The mountain does not care which country is the best. Across the Andes, the ancient Andes, through the clouds their peaks do proudly show. Across the ancient Andes, following the trails of long ago. Brave Mapuche settled here until the Spanish came. Swiss and German, French, Italian, all have staked a claim. Earthquake, wars, volcanoes, to the earth, but who's to blame? The mountains do not care about the language of your name. Across the ancient Andes, through the clouds their peaks do proudly show. Across the ancient Andes, following the trails of long ago. Thank you. Thank you. I'd like to close with a story from 1987. I was a teacher and I was sent on an exchange program to teach in a rural middle school in Norway, of all places. In fact, one of the people in the audience tonight, my colleague Brenda Lee, was sent on an exchange too. So hi, Brenda, good to see you tonight. Anyway, I got to Norway and my students did not speak a word of English. And my Norwegian wasn't so good, as you can imagine. So what to do? Well, in those years, I didn't go anywhere without my guitar. And I composed a simple song with easy English words, and we sang it to each other all the time. And eventually they made Norwegian words for the song too. And we bonded through the miracle of music. So I'd like you to join me in singing this simple song. You have the words to the chorus on your screen. You have to stay muted because Zoom hasn't figured out how we can sing together yet. Friends near and far, friends wherever you are, you are. Somehow got muted. Start again. Friends near and far, friends wherever you are, if you have an open heart, you'll have friends near and far. When you feel all alone, no one calls on the phone. Don't just sit around and moan, or you'll have no friends of your own. Everybody, friends near and far, friends wherever you are. If you have an open heart, you'll have friends near and far. People everywhere all need love and care. Norway, Russia, USA, it's the same everywhere. Everybody, friends near and far, friends wherever you are. If you have an open heart, you'll have friends near and far. I'm so looking forward to hearing Stephanie Lynn Smith and Lee and Michael Stone. Thanks for being here tonight.
Thank you, Marilyn. That was absolutely fantastic. Everyone, one more round of applause. You only hear me, but one more round of applause for Marilyn, please. Can we follow that act, you're asking yourselves? Well, we can try. I think we can do it. Next on our itinerary is the formidable Stephanie Lynn Smith. She has been the artistic director and conductor for several gala choruses in the San Francisco Bay Area. She's been the cantor of the Cathedral in San Francisco, and she's been the pianist and slide guitarist performing with the New York and Los Angeles Philharmonics on the Bugs Bunny at the Symphony Tour. She's been touring with the Broadway vet Cavalier Frank D'Ambrosio since 2012. And Stephanie is now the artistic director for the Northwest Queer Chorus, based in Portland, Oregon. And she's a performance coach and producer in the Bay Area and also in Oregon's Willamette Valley. Her Miss Smith Presents live streams have raised over $15,000 for nonprofits since the beginning of the pandemic. So please join me in welcoming Stephanie Lynn Smith.
Thank you, throngs of people applauding. That was awesome. Hi, everybody. I am Stephanie Lynn Smith. I am broadcasting from Salem, Oregon, in my studio here, and it is so great to be with you. The last live show I did was 2 days before lockdown, and it was for Lisa Benson, who I believe is on this call right now. I think I saw her. And it was on March the 14th at Resound. So I'm going to call this a song about travel. I love my friends and they love me. We're just as close as we can be. And just because we really care, whatever we get, we share. I got it from Agnes and she got it from Jim. We all agree it must have been Louise who gave it to him. Now she got it from Harry, who got it from Marie. And everybody knows that Marie got it from me. Giles got it from Daphne, and she got it from Joan, who picked it up, a county clerk, a kiss in the Blarney Stone. Pierre gave it to Sheila, who must have brought it there. He got it from Francois and Jacques. Aha! Lucky Pierre. Max got it from Edith, who gets it every spring. She got it from her daddy, who just gives her everything. Ugh. She then gave it to Daniel, whose spaniel has it now. Our dentist even got it, and we're still wondering how. But I got it from Agnes, or maybe it was Sue, or Millie, or Billy, or Gilly, or Willie, it doesn't matter who. It might have been at the pub, or at the club, or at the loo, or at the church, or at the school. And if you can be my friend, then I might. Mind you, I said might. Give it to you. Okay, so that was Tom Lehrer from 1953. I just think that's incredible every time. So he's in his 90s now. And I remember the show with Lisa Benson. We had 75 people possible in the space. And when we found out, you know, they were talking about this virus and something called social distancing, and we thought, oh my goodness. And actually, we put out a message to people and said, do you still want to come? And they said, oh yeah, I'm not missing this. It's like, all right, because Lisa rocks. So we spread the chairs apart. We reduced the ticket sales to 50 people. And we had an outstanding show. It was really, really cool. But that is the last time. And I, you know, I still have not been compensated by Brown Paper Tickets. I'm not quite sure that they made it, that they survived. But Miss Smith has survived, and Society Cabaret is still here. So it's just really cool to be with all of you people, and I'm thank you for the invitation, Society Cabaret. So usually when I perform, I wear something that my mother made, always. I tour with something that my mother made. So today, I wanted to show you what I wear when I travel. This is literally my travel outfit. And I am an Alaska Airlines fan. I'm an MVP, and I always wear this shirt because you get priority boarding. And I understand they are sponsors of a football, soccer team, and so get on the, I'm gonna walk away from that. Okay, also, I am notorious for packing light. This is my travel bag. I travel all over the country. This holds my music. It has my iPad. It's got everything in here. I do have to say, can't travel with the hair goo. Had to kind of figure that out. It's too big, and this is like expensive, and the TSA is not taking this. Let's just put it that way. So in my bag, I am always ready for coffee. I have a cute little spoon at a little boutique hotel, right? And somewhere, I can't remember where it was, my Cafe Bustelo instant coffee. Hello. I take sugar, so I have a lot of these. Steal them from the airline. Okay. And then, of course, mini moos. I'm ready to have coffee anytime, anywhere. I do have to give a shout out to Australia because they made pawpaw ointment. Can't buy it anywhere. And this is like, this is the, okay, I'm not going to tell you what I use that for. I always have electrolytes in here somewhere, June, you know. But the most important thing that's in my bag, a microphone adapter, because I will never, ever, ever be stuck again. You know, and I also keep some things in here like, you know, a good, you never know. I feel like I've got something in here that makes me feel better about myself. There it is, my little rock, Let It Be. Travel with that. Sometimes I need extra shoes because I'm going to San Francisco. And then I add on the backpack, okay? This, I love this backpack. Evidently, this is a sporty, nice thing. I don't know. It was given to me by Tony La Russa. Stars to the Rescue at the Lesher Center. Chicago is in that show. Tony La Russa. I think he's in baseball. Yeah. And he also gave me an autographed baseball diamond. So that's what I travel with. That's my bag, in case everybody wanted in on the secrets there, you know. And it's true, I tour with Frank. I don't tour with Bugs Bunny at the Symphony anymore. Those were amazing gigs. We got the greatest hotels. I mean, the Westin in Edmonton, Canada is like a castle. I mean, just the most spectacular places, right? Frank and me? Yeah, not so much. We see the inside of lots of motels. Oh, my Aunt Janet would love to host you. We're like, awesome. Love Aunt Janet. She was great. But, you know, lots of stories about food. There's a lot of stuff in his rider. I eat meat, you know, and he needs no bread, no dairy, right? So I remember one time we were in Washington State somewhere that took a very, very long time to get to, like we would fly in, I don't know, I'm bad with geography, because I'm from Texas, we only know about us. So there's, you know, we land here, and then we were going here, but you had to drive all the way over. So some people are like, I know exactly where she's talking about. But it was hideous, it was like a 6 a.m. flight. Poor Frank picked me up at 8, drove me, you know, and we landed, they were so nice to us, but the ladies of the auxiliary club have made you dinner. We're like, oh my God, we're famished. And they gave us these shells, like a shell, and it just was filled with mayonnaise. I don't know. It was like it was mayonnaise and fish, and you know, and we're both so polite. We were like, oh, thank you so much. You know, and there were potatoes with it, right? And Frank looked at me when they left and he goes, Oh, honey, I can't eat that. And I go, if I don't eat something, I'm going to die. And so give me your clam thing. I'm from Texas. I'm indestructible. We eat mayonnaise. And so I can handle this thing, and I need something to get on stage with. And he ate the potatoes. That was we did well, but so I have lots of stories like that. You know, so many hotels, many planes, not a lot of vegetables, can't ever find a cocktail after 7 p.m. I don't know what the deal is, you know. But he and I are really great travel partners. We like a good thrift store. So whenever he picks me up from the airport, I have already investigated all of the antique shops and thrift stores that are in the area with a printout. He loves me. So the next piece that I want to do is by a local composer, Morris Bobro. I have to get his name right. I always said it wrong. Bobro. He said, I'm so tired of people saying my name wrong. And I just did. Bobro. So, you know, if I were to travel, right, like me, I'm going on vacation, me personally, Stephanie, where would I go? What would I do? And there was a song in a great little show that he did. It was called Are We Almost There? And Jackie DeMuro is on this call. She was in that show. I remember her, this was about travel, and her song was "Eating in My Car." I'm eating in my car. I was like, you did a lot with "Eating in My Car," right? He wrote "Foodies the Musical." He wrote "Shopping the Musical." Y'all remembering this? Okay, yeah. So this one is from, are we almost there? From 2001, and I would imagine this situation is even more difficult now with all the liberals, you know, wanting to keep everybody healthy. I don't know. I went to my travel agent to find a vacation spot in a country that would match up with the tastes I have got. Didn't care about sandy beaches or ruins to explore. I was real clear describing what I was looking for. A place where I can smoke anytime, anywhere, without worrying I'm guilty of a crime. I mean in restaurants wherever I am touring, before the meal, after, or damn it, during. My agent said she'd have to check it out then very soon. She booked me in a small hotel in eastern Cameroon. The walls were thin as paper and the bed felt like cement. And I had no running water, but I could puff to my heart's content. I smoked a pack at breakfast, another pack at lunch. And just 'cause I could, I smoked another pack at brunch. It's second nature there, and they light up often. And it's music to my ears, the sound of people coughing. The next year I did Indonesia, which is short on regulations. It's a place where doctors smoke as they're diagnosing patients. Then I grabbed a bargain basement trip for summer in Cambodia. 'Cause even if you're 12 and buying smokes, Cambodia won't say no to ya. They say smoke on, I say amen. When I get wanderlust, I yearn for Phnom Penh. They love cigarettes there, they smoke them by the batches. And the best part is everyone you ask has matches. I'm mad about Madagascar, it's a smoker's wonderland. You can breathe in all the smoke you want, whether first or second hand. You grab your pack of cigarettes when you wake up in the morning, and you don't have to endure that goddamn Surgeon General's warning. You can have Jerusalem with its holy places. Let me smoke for 3 weeks in unventilated spaces. I'll take Samoa for my next vacation flight, 'cause that's where smoking is a civil right. Give me that nicotine scene. Yeah. Applause, Tim, really? Oh, I see. Oh. You know, my mother's on this call, so I just want to be really clear, Mom. I do not smoke cigarettes. Just marijuana. Promise, no tobacco, I swear. But let me tell you where they smoke, and I think Marilyn has already taken us to this place tonight, France. We were very happy there. In July 2008, I proposed to Jen Brown. She said yes. We eloped in September of 2008 at San Francisco City Hall, and then we went with our wedding party across the street to Topps Diner. Let's take a second. Rest in peace, Topps Diner. Topps Diner didn't make it. And then we all just went back to work. I think the first appointment was, you know, 9 a.m., so we took it. We went back to work. But for the honeymoon, I asked Jen. I had just gotten a bonus from work, and, you know, it's like, we can get a ticket anywhere in the world. Where would you like to go for honeymoon? She's like, well, I mean, of course, Paris. And I said, okay. And she goes, no, I mean, I'd love to go there, but I can't. I'm like, it's just a place. You just buy a ticket, you go there, you know? And so we bought tickets and we spent a month in Paris for our honeymoon. What did we do? Absolutely nothing. If you want to know if we saw it, we didn't see it. We did not see it. We stayed on United States time zone. I think we woke up at 4 o'clock every day. Honestly, we went to the Louvre. It was closing. We went back the next day, caught another hour or two. It's just, we can't. Yeah, anyway. So we do what we do. We sat around drinking coffee, watching fashion, watching people without a lot of makeup, with fabulous coats. And they were just so civilized. You'd see two people talking to each other in these fabulous jeans. Their clothes are so good. And then they would come and sit down, and they would order a little cup of coffee, smoke a cigarette, talk to each other, pay, and get up and leave. It's like they sit down to have coffee, smoke a little, and leave. It was just, we just watched people. It was really great. But the story from Paris I want to tell you is the Eiffel Tower. So we're walking on one of our unplanned days, and I don't know how this happened, but I promise you it happened just this way. We walked out, and suddenly there's the Eiffel Tower. Like, how do we not see the Eiffel Tower coming? But we didn't. We're just, it's like, oh, it's the Eiffel Tower. We should go see it since we haven't seen anything. And so we go to the Eiffel Tower, but there's a line. We don't wait in line for anybody. So we said, we'll be back later. I don't know, still haven't come back, but we're going to, anyway. And so we walked a little further and found this cute little cafe that was like right under it, basically, just right there, and it started to rain. So we're like, should probably jump in here for just a second, sit down and let the rain pass, right? So we walk in the front door, and we are greeted with, this guy looks like the chef from The Little Mermaid. He literally has, it's Johnny G's, like, awesome handlebar mustache, and he literally goes, oh, ho, ho, welcome to this cafe. Oh, ho, we are so glad to have you here. Oh, ho. And we're just, hi, this is, you know, okay, it's, oh, let me show you over here to your table, you know. And so when he left, we went, oh, it's probably like John from Jersey. He's like, you know, came over here as an actor. Like, he probably went back to the kitchen and was like, gosh, you know, man. But it was hilarious. He was just, oh, 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 you know. And so we're sitting here. We realize where we are. We're like, okay, we're in a tourist place. That's fine, but it's raining, so whatever. And in walks, they're like 68 to 75, somewhere in there, man and woman. This guy walks in. And in just an American accent, he looks at this guy as loud as he could. Y'all got a toilet? I gotta go. That's what we remember. That's what we remember. Paris. Yes, lovely place. This is a great song that Paul James France wrote. And I'm pleased he redid the opening at my request. Enjoy. We used to be great travelers, but now we never roam. Save behind our COVID masks, we isolate at home. But now we hear from Fauci, there's a new vaccine. We can't wait, we've set the date, no more quarantine. I wanna sit where Sartre sat. We'll sip espressos and we'll chat about life's emptiness and misery. We'll see that Moulin Rouge. We're gonna drive there in our Peugeot. That's French for car. Take it from me. We'll head down to the Louvre. All those pictures you'll say you feel like you've been swept back into history. We'll see Mona Lisa smile. We'll hang with Mona for a while. 'cause she's looking at you and me. We'll dine on French cuisine, gourmet meals, and in between, pastries, chocolates, goodies till our buttons burst. We'll just keep on eating, 'cause around every corner's a treat, and to leave a sweet treat uneaten, that would be the worst. You'll shop for haute couture, endless fittings you'll endure, till at last you're ready to star in your own fashion show. We'll climb the Eiffel Tower and pass the midnight hour, watching lights come on all across the city below. Hey, bass player, vamp for a second. I forgot to say something. I forgot to say, when we landed, it was November the 5th, 2008. Barack Obama was elected president. You'll put on your best gowns, and we'll step out on the town. We're gonna dance till two like Rogers and Astaire. We'll find a late night brasserie and eat oysters, you and me. We'll make romance Parisian style in the cool night air. We'll walk home along the Seine. I'll look into your eyes and then I'll say je t'aime, you'll say ditto for me. Snapple of the next one planned, 'cause we can't wait. No, no, we can't wait. We just can't wait to get back to Paris. Thanks. Oh, man, it was so amazing to land in Paris and Barack Obama had been elected. You would have thought that he was their president. There were T-shirts all over the newspapers. I saved them. It was just so, so great to be an American. So great in that moment. So I love my local and living composers. So Paul James France, just thank you so very much. It's my pleasure to champion your works. Thanks for editing that. And, you know, folks, I got a couple of upcoming shows since I have you here. You're stuck, so I got to tell you. So next week I have Karen Sikich, who is unbelievable. The next day on Valentine's Day, the Sisters of Perpetual Indulgence. Miss Smith has presented a show. Let's just call it a show. It's going to be great. This is all on my website. And then I know he is on this call right now, Don Martin and his long hair. That is February the 20th. He has been vaccinated not once, not twice, and he has vaccinated his entire staff. And I happen to know he doesn't like anyone to come anywhere near him, so he's safe, you know. This will be great. So he's on February the 20th, and all of these things are on my website, MissSmithPresents.com. Just my pleasure. So all of these thoughts about traveling, where do I want to go, what do I want to do, you know, whatever. And I haven't seen my parents since November the 30th, 2019. It was right here in this room. We had a studio blessing. And yeah, where would I go? Can't believe I'm going to say this. I go to Texas. I would. So to close you out, I want to sing a little set here. Let's call it I'll Fly Away, right? Some glad morning when this life is o'er, I'll fly away to a home on on God's celestial shore, I'll fly away. I wish that I could fly into the sky so very high, just like a dragonfly. I'd fly above the trees, over the seas, in all degrees, to anywhere I please. See the stars, the Milky Way, or even Mars. Well, we could just be us. Let's fade into the sun, let your spirits fly where we are one, and just for a little fun. Wichita Falls, Texas. You're never gonna hear me say that again, I swear to God. Odd Duck coffee and barbecue and Tex-Mex and lots of mayonnaise. But what I came to say is Whataburger is so much better than In-N-Out. Oh, Bay Area, my my sinner, my composer, my Shane and my Dave. I heart Joe Carroll. I miss Maria Diamond. Fancy Venus Tam at midnight, dim sum, facials and nails and bad kung fu dubbing. Make me a cappuccino and draw me a pretty tree. Or whatever the heck that was, I know you're getting better at it. My husband, weed at midnight and bark at the morning. But what I really miss, yes, what I really miss is his brown sugar meatloaf. I wanna get away.
Thank you, Stephanie. That was, I think that there's some pretty stiff competition for who's going to get to be the travel agent when this is all over. You managed to work in at least a voting majority of the seven deadly sins, and again in that last song. So really fantastic. Another big round of applause again, please, everyone. Well, let's get a third opinion. Finally, Lee Stone is going to guide us home. Lee has been performing professionally for more than 40 years. She's worked in multiple theaters in Southern California, and she's sung in many top 40 show and jazz groups in venues around the world. She's currently on the production team of Desert Theatricals in Rancho Mirage, and she regularly performs with her husband, Michael, as the group Tin Man's Heart. Take it away, Lee.
Why, thank you. Can everybody hear us? Yes? Good. Welcome. Wow, what an act to follow. So yes, I'm Lee, this is Michael. We perform as Tin Man's Heart. While I have you, if you like us, we do Facebook Live concerts every other Monday, next Monday. Look for Tin Man's Heart on Facebook and you'll see us. So yeah, I don't play piano. I try during our shows, but I kind of suck. So I had to have Michael here to play for me, and we love to sing together. So so travel, wow. We love to travel. We've been together about 18 years and we've traveled a lot together, and we traveled a lot separately before that because both of us have been professional musicians for most of our lives. So we have a lot of road stories and a lot of stuff like that. He's letting me do most of the talking because he's a little shy and
Yeah, right.
She
knows what she wants to say.
Yeah. Like Maryland, one of our favorite places to go is actually Kauai. I bought a timeshare there 35 years ago, and I'm one of those lucky people who uses it all the time. We go every other year for 2 weeks, and we have a lot of fun while we're there. Last year, we had to cancel, so we're looking forward to getting back on schedule with that, but I didn't really know any ukulele songs, so we're not going to do any songs about Hawaii. So even though we've both flown a lot, as a matter of fact, I was an Air Force brat, so yeah, I flew a lot when I was young, and we've flown all over the place. But our favorite thing to do as a family is to take road trips.
And she drives.
I drive. I do all the driving. And our favorite trip that we took was in 2018 with our brother Danny, who lives with us. And he called it the Discover America trip.
And it was.
It was 31 days, 7,100.1 miles.
That she drove.
That I drove. 19 states And I'm getting a little hiss. 19 states. And we visited friends and family in Missouri, Illinois, Ohio, Pennsylvania, South Carolina, and Georgia. And we had a wonderful time. And but one of our favorite days that we spent, we only had one day here, but we were in Memphis and we got to spend the afternoon visiting Graceland. And we were practically the only people in the entire place, which is a lot smaller than I expected. I always thought it was going to be this big mansion, but no, it was pretty small, actually. But it was beautiful and so much fun. And this song reminds us of that. It's called Walking in Memphis by Mark Cohn.
Put on my blue suede shoes and I boarded the plane. Touched down in the land of the Delta Blues in the middle of the pouring rain. WC Handy, won't you look out over me? Yeah, I got a first class ticket, but I'm as blue as a girl can be when I'm walking in Memphis. I was walking with my feet 10 feet off a beam, walking in Memphis. But do I really feel the way I feel? Yeah. I saw the ghost of Elvis on Union Avenue. I followed him up to the gates of Graceland, and I watched him walk right through. Now security didn't see him, they just hovered around his tomb. But there's a pretty little thing waiting for the king down in the jungle room. Yeah, I'm walking in Memphis.
Walking in Memphis.
I'm walking with my feet 10 feet off the field. I'm walking in Memphis.
Walking in Memphis.
Do I really feel the way I feel? They've got catfish on the table. They've got gospel in the air. And Reverend Green, be glad to meet you. When you haven't got a prayer, but boy, you got a prayer in Memphis. Now Mira plays piano every Friday at the Hollywood. And they brought me down to see her, and they asked me if I would sing a little number, and I sang for my mind. She said, tell me, are you a Christian child? And I said, ma'am, I am tonight. Yeah, I'm walking in Memphis.
Walking in Memphis.
Walking with my feet 10 feet off the field. Walking in Memphis.
Walking in Memphis.
But do I really feel the way I feel? Walking in Memphis.
Memphis.
Yeah, I'm walking with my feet 10 feet off the field. Walking in Memphis. Do I really feel the way I feel? Yeah. Put on my blue suede shoes and I boarded the plane. Touched
goodness. It's so fun to hear applause, even if you know it's canned, because when we do our Facebook Live, we never get applause. I mean, we get emojis, lots of emojis, which is always fun, but we don't hear applause. So it's been a while since we did a live show as well. Oh, okay. I have to bump the volume.
Got a real pretty song here. Well, I'll let you tell it about it.
Okay.
It's a real pretty one.
It is. So on our trip, we also went to Georgia. We got to visit with friends in Atlanta. And we spent a lot of time, or not as much time as we'd like, in Savannah, which is someplace that we'd like to spend a lot of time, because it's really kind of amazing and beautiful, and the architecture is incredible. And you can walk around, oh gosh, 22 of the squares still, and see all the mosques and the statues and the fountains, and walk along the riverfront and see the cannons that are still there.
Johnny Mercer's house.
Johnny Mercer's house, yeah. And the stairs that, you know, go up like this. It's just the coolest place. And excuse me, I'm gonna get something to drink.
You can also see the bench that was in Forrest Gump.
That's right, I forgot about that. Yeah, we got our vaccinations yesterday, and it's kind of affecting my voice a little bit. Weird. Anyway, this next song is called Georgia Rain by Trisha Yearwood. And it just reminds us to go back to Georgia and Savannah someday. Barefoot in the truck of your truck. Let's do that again.
Truck of your truck.
Barefoot in the bed of your truck. On a blanket looking up. Half a moon peeking down at us from underneath the clouds. Teenage kids sneaking out again. We heard the thunder rolling in. We were falling the moment when it all came pouring down. The Georgia rain on the Jasper County clay couldn't wash away. Nothing in our way except for the Georgia rain. Cotton fields remember when flash of lightning drove us in. We were soaked down to the skin by the time we climbed inside. And I don't remember what was pounding more, my heart in my chest or the hood of that Ford. As the sky fell in and the storm clouds poured, worlds away outside. The Georgia rain. Wash away all the love we made. Just you and me down an old dirt road. No one saw a thing except for the Georgia rain. Green door flapping in the wind. Same old house I grew up in. I can't believe I'm back again after all these years away. Fixed your daddy's house up nice.
I saw it yesterday when I drove by. Looks like you've made yourself a real nice life. What more can I say? The Georgia rain on the Jasper County clay couldn't wash away the way I loved you to this day. Your dirt road's paved over now, nothing here's the same. Except for the Georgia rain couldn't wash away the way I loved you to this day. Just you and me down an old dirt road, nothing in our way. Except for the Georgia rain. That's so fun. I always just go, that's our idea of applause. So yeah, that was a great road trip. We had a lot of fun and we're hoping to go back. We were supposed to go back last year too, because we have lots of friends and family. Michael went to school in Belleville, Illinois, and we missed a reunion last year. We're gonna try and do it again this year, maybe. We'll see what happens. But also in the future, when it's safe to fly again, we're hoping to get to Europe. We've both been there separately, not together, and we have kind of fantasies about going to Paris like everybody else. It's a common theme tonight. Our Paris song's a little bit different though, because I love Joni Mitchell. And so we're gonna do a Joni Mitchell song. It's called Free Man in Paris. That's it? Yep.
Can't please them all. There's always somebody bringing you down. I do my best and I do a good business. There's a lot of people asking for my time, trying to get ahead, trying to be a good friend of mine. I was a free man in Paris. I felt unfettered and alive. There was nobody calling me up for favors, and no one's future to decide. And no, I'd go back there tomorrow, but for the work I've taken on, stoking the strong, making machinery behind the popular song. Walk through those doors and wander down the Champs-Élysées, going cafe to cabaret, thinking how I'd feel when I find a very good friend of mine. I was a free man in Paris. I felt unfettered and alive. There was nobody calling me up for favors. No one's future to decide. I know I'd
up all the work I've taken on. Stopping the strong, making machinery behind the popular song.
Okay, let's see. All right, well, another trip that we are hoping to take together, because we've never been together, is someplace else that has been talked about tonight, and that's New York City. And we've both been there before.
You betcha.
Michael actually performed at a club called Shout, which was right off Times Square. In 1988,
way back when, 1988.
And I've been there for a long theater weekend. And when I used to work before I retired, I used to have to do a lot of projects in Jersey City. So we would like pop over for lunch and stuff. But I was always working at night and never got to see any theater, which was a total drag. But we're hoping to go together someday so that we can explore everything as a couple and enjoy the food and the music in the theater and
dirty dogs on the sidewalk, you know, those are the best.
Yeah. And so our last song is one of our favorites that we do fairly often. We get requested a lot. It was originally recorded in 1964 by the Ad-Libs, but our favorite version was released in 1981 by Manhattan Transfer, and it is Boy from New York City. No.
Ooh-ah, ooh-ah, cuckoo kitty, talking about the boy from New York City. Ooh-ah, ooh-ah, come on, kitty, tell us about the boy from New York. He's kind of tall. He's really fine. Yeah, yeah. Someday I hope to make him mine, oh mine.
Yeah, yeah.
And he's neat and does so sweet. And just the way he looks at me, he knocks me off my feet.
Yeah, yeah.
About the boy from New York City. He's really down, and he's no clown.
Yeah, yeah.
He's got the finest penthouse I've ever seen in town.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and he's cute in his no-hair suit, and keeps his pockets full of spending.
Yeah, yeah.
Ooh, ooh-ah, ooh-ah, cuckoo kitty, talking about the boy from New York City. Ooh-ah, ooh-ah, come on, kitty, tell us about the boy from New York City. Ooh-ah, ooh-ah, cuckoo kitty, talking about the boy from New York City.
Thanks, everybody. Thanks for having us.
Thanks a lot.
That was Tin Man's Heart. Thank you, Lee and Michael. That really gets me. We get so few chances to hear vocal harmony in the same room. You know, if you can go back, like, who would you choose to be quarantined with? Those folks got it right. I want to go back and thank everyone one more time. So how about a big round of applause for all of our performers from up and down the West Coast, Maryland and Stephanie and Lee and Michael. And thanks to Tim in the booth. And thank you from all of us to you, the audience. Thank you all so much for coming. Without you, none of us would be here. So before we go, let me mention the next shows coming up at Society Cabaret. On Friday, March 5th, we'll have Curtain Call, open mic. Then on Saturday, March 6th, we'll have the show Pet Tales, another showcase with sets by Marlene Sharp, Jackie DeMuro, who I think I saw here, and Carolyn Power. They'll be singing about the furry friends in their lives. And then the next month, on April 9th, we'll have Curtain Call again. And on April 10th, I will host the next Songs and Their Stories, which will be a review of the songs of lyricist Carolyn Lee, sung by the all-star cast of Society Regulars. And you can get tickets for all of those events at societycabaret.com. We will leave the Zoom session up for a bit, so you can chat with the performers if you'd like. Have a great night, and we'll see you next time at Society Cabaret.
Thanks, Dave. That was fabulous. I love the hat.
Thanks, Tim. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, everybody who showed up tonight. It was wonderful to see people from coast to coast. And Paul, I loved hearing your songs.
Oh, yeah, thank you. I loved all of you. You did a great job.
How much fun to have people from all across the whole country. That's terrific.
That's wonderful.
I want to know how you do the applause.
Just have to share your screen sounds and then find an applause track.
That's it.
And then it's all about timing.
Yeah, that's it. I want to train somebody to do that. Yeah,
you have to understand how, you know, the cadence of a performance. When's the song?
Yeah. It's a good idea.
Yeah.
I think your rates are reasonable, aren't they, Tim?
Yeah, I'm cheap. Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, actually, yeah. But I think it sounded like the performers really, I would think that it feels good to hear actual applause while we're doing this, because
absolutely. Anyway. No, you can't, that's not very satisfying, but actually having the sound. It was also a trick finding the right sound, because there's a lot of applause sounds out there, but most of them are just not right. So,
can I email you for the link?
Sure. Yeah.
Okay.
Good job, everybody. It was wonderful.
Oh, you're Tim that I emailed about my ticket. Okay, great. Thanks.
I put it in the chat just in case.
Zana,
right?
Zan. Where do you live, Zan? I've seen you on these a lot.
Salem, Oregon.
Oh, really? Oh, okay. Well, thanks for showing up all the time.
Thanks. Nice. Well, Stephanie is my coach, so.
Oh, okay.
So I got inside reason to be here.
Yay.
Are you a singer too? Is she coaching you in singing?
Yes.
Nice. So when are we going to get to hear you one of these days?
Maybe.
Yes. Yes.
Maybe.
I'm not Zoom video ready, but I just wanted to tell everybody it was a wonderful show. I loved it. I loved the way you had different takes on travel and all the song choices. It was wonderful. Thank you.
Thanks for always showing up, Joanne. I love you. We go way back.
We do, Marilyn. Yeah. I was happy to hear learned so much about all the travel you and John have done. That was a lot of fun.
It's been a great privilege. And Merle and Larry lounging over there, like the New Yorkers over there.
Hi, Merle. Hi, Larry.
Can't believe the New Yorkers are still awake.
They're actually in California now.
Oh, okay. There you go.
We got caught here and just on the 27th of February and haven't been able to leave since. Well.
Been an interesting year.
Must miss your grandchild.
I do. I miss them terribly. I do. Thank God, and I thought I'd never say this, for technology.
Yes. Who knew?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right.
Oh, yeah.
You obviously did, Tim.
Yeah. Working well.
It's working, yeah.
Did a great job, Marilyn.
Yay, Marilyn.
Marilyn, you astound me with your talent in songwriting and playing and singing. I mean, I stand in awe, seriously. Your songs are really wonderful. And
very artful. Wonderful
and
stuff.
You know, they drew me in, and I wanted to go to all. I've been to most of the places you were singing about, but it still made me want to go back.
Where they are, yeah. Like I just have to be there to write them down. It's kind of how it is.
Mm.
And there's Carol. I love your look tonight, Carol.
Oh. My shirt.
Oh.
Wait, you got to see my shirt. But I can't, let's see, wait. See my shirt?
Oh,
all right.
Girls can do anything.
I love it.
Yeah, well, it's my eye. I just hiding it and trying to stay low.
How are you feeling today? Is it better?
Better, a little bit better, a little bit. I'm just trying to, I have to work tomorrow, so I'm trying to stay low today. No makeup, you know, hat.
Well, Dave, you did a wonderful job standing in for Scott and Tim.
Oh, yeah.
Tim and Dave, can you let Scott know we're all thinking about him and sending him the best?
Absolutely will.
Love that hat, Dave.
Hat's a keeper.
Hey, gotta be in the hat club. I bought this hat for a bachelor party years ago. I wore a black suit and a hat the entire weekend. It was in Las Vegas.
Of course,
it had to be.
But it didn't stay in Las Vegas.
Oh, yeah. I'm leaving a lot of stuff in Las Vegas.
The Moras are lurking in the background there.
Yeah, I know. I saw them.
Very sneaky.
Yeah, there they are.
Well, I appreciate that you're doing this little conversation time because I haven't seen a lot of these, you know, we don't get to talk much, so.
No, nice to have a little bit afterwards.
Marie, I don't know you. Where are you from? How are you connected here tonight? Jean Marie?
Oh, she's muted. You're muted, Jean Marie.
I'm a student of Stephanie's and Sue.
Uh-huh. Great. So will we be hearing you at Curtain Call one of these nights?
Who knows? Maybe. I do have a few things I'm working on.
You live up in Oregon as well?
Yes, in Salem.
Nice.
It's nice. We can do Curtain Call from anywhere now. Don't have to
That's
be in San Francisco.
Right.
I know. I had my friend here last night from Chicago.
There you go.
When I saw his name on the list, I was like, "There can't is that really my friend Kevin?" And it was.
It's brilliant.
Nice addition too.
Yes.
Yeah, he was. He actually, we did a chat, you know, on the Facebook chat, and he loved our group. I'll just give you this feedback. He said everybody seems so supportive. He just loved it. So I think that says something for the community and the tone that Society is Cabaret has set, Tim. So I thought that was lovely.
That's so wonderful. Thanks.
Yeah, nice to get somebody's feedback that, you know, isn't part of the gang, so to speak.
Yeah,
get that viewpoint,
because you guys all, you have to say those sort of things.
Yeah, we have to, because otherwise you won't let us sing.
All right, that's right.
But really, he was very, very impressed, and I think we'll see him again. And there's another woman from that same group who's hilarious, who writes her own songs, who was also supposed to come, and he was, but she didn't. So I'm going to encourage her to show up. She's part of that Chicago gang.
Right on.
I'm thinking we could cross-pollinate. They do an open mic at Davenport's.
Oh, okay, great.
I asked him, and so I'm going to check in with on that and talk to him a little bit more about whether or not we could start doing stuff like that. I think it'd be fun.
Absolutely. I've always thought there would be, in fact, I talked a little bit about it to Ben Bacow, about the idea of doing a little field trip, of taking some cabaret folks up to Seattle and then doing a vice versa thing, having some Seattle folks come down to San Francisco. You know, we could put them up and then do a show or two, kind of cross-pollinate, like you said, our cabaret culture.
Well, you know, it's interesting because, you know, June and I met a lovely woman from Seattle. Oh, she's known her, but I met her when we went to the Fairbanks Summer Arts Festival. And she's a jazz singer, and she does a lot of shows. And now that you're saying that, I mean, but we don't have to travel now. We could just...
We can just do it with the Zoom.
We could just do it with Zoom.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
I'll talk to June and see if she thinks Greta might think that would be something to be fun, because at least we're all on the same coast and we wouldn't have the time zone thing.
Right, right. Good idea.
Who knows what could happen here?
Yeah. Okay, all you fabulous people, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up. Thanks so much for hanging out with us and talking for a bit. We'll see
you. Bye, all. Okay, bye. Have a good rest of the weekend. Good to see you all.
Thank you, everyone.
See you all soon.
See you soon, hopefully.